Radar charts allow you to compare various items against each other where there is more than one criteria per item. So in this example, we've got various cell phone packages, and we've got the cost of a call on net, off net, and to the fixed line operator. And what we want to do is compare to see which package looks the best. So we can highlight the data, we go to other charts, and at the bottom we've got something called radar, sometimes referred to as spider graphs. If I click on it, we get something that looks like this. I'm just going to make it a bit bigger. What the chart shows us is on each axis, in this case there's three axes because we had three criteria, it gives us an axis and it gives us the costs. And what it has plotted is what each package's cost is for that area. So we can see just by looking that the red line, which is package 2, appears to be on average the most expensive. In all cases, it's the most expensive. Looking here, we can see the blue line is the most expensive with on-net calls. So fairly close call for the off-net, but it seems to be just a little bit lower for the fixed line. And the green seems to be the best, the package 3, because the majority of them it's either the lowest or very close to the lowest. As with all charts, all these items are formattable and customizable. Something we like to do with radar charts is the grid lines. So if I click on it, it's quite useful to remove them. So if you click on it and you just push delete, you'll see the grid lines are removed, and sometimes that makes it just a little bit easier to see. If you wish to, you can right click on one of the series and format it. You'll see the options are generally the same in all areas. Under the radar chart you have one extra item which refers to the category labels. You'll see if I switch it off, all that happens is these labels disappear. In our opinion, it's useful to know what those labels are referring to, so we would leave it on.